I haven't posted many videos about Battlefront 2 recently, and I think it's pretty obvious why that might be. The reaction since launch has been pretty terrible, and I wanted to just let the dust settle before jumping back in. I did make a few videos at the launch of the game, but they got hit pretty hard with negativity, and I genuinely just didn't want to deal with it, so I'm coming back to it now because DICE has issued an update today to the credit gain, and we've got some details on the Last Jedi season that is launching tomorrow. Let's see if these credit changes are a step in the right direction. So firstly, the credit gain update is one that happens in the background. You don't need to download anything for it to work. Simply launch the game and this update will have been applied. If you were playing the game when the update was applied, shut your game, completely turn it off, and relaunch it again, and the update should have applied for you. Area number one that's been addressed is the amount of credits that you earn after a match in multiplayer. DICE agreed with the community that the credit payout needed to better reflect individual player performance, and they've increased the overall amount of credits you get for completing a round, and further increased the amount of credits handed out to top performing players in that round. Now, what I'd like to have seen is a breakdown of how these credits are actually awarded, with percentages showing us whether it's weighted towards performance or game duration, but at least we're getting more points overall now. I played a couple of rounds of Galactic Assault before this video. I got 615 credits, I think, in one game, and 610 in another, which means now it's going to take roughly 4 games of Galactic Assault before you can afford to open up the cheapest crate in the game at the moment, and to me, that's a good step in the right direction. Area number two that's been addressed, DICE has increased the amount of credits awarded for completing arcade scenarios. The daily cap has been increased from 500 to 1500 credits a day, that's 3 times more than previous. For people who like completing these offline missions, then this is obviously a good change, and in general, I think this is good for everyone. 1500 credits is only 500 away from the cheapest crate again, so just 5 rounds of arcade gets you closer to unlocking some new star cards, providing they're not duplicates. And area number 3 that's seen some changes is within the daily crates that are handed out. The amount of crafting parts in those has been increased from 5 to 15, effective immediately. This means you'll collect more of these crafting parts as time goes on, and you should be able to craft up star card levels a little bit faster, or unlock weapon mods for different blasters that you like to use. Now, DICE has said this point particularly is important to them, as crafting parts are the currency that you guys use to progress through the game the way that you want to, not having to solely rely on random crate openings to get the star cards that you want to play with. These crafting parts are fairly important, and it's nice to see that the level has been bumped up a little bit. Now, these might not sound like huge changes overall, but DICE has left another note in its blog post. These changes are just the beginning. More will be coming, but for those changes to arrive, more work needs to be done. Essentially, DICE is looking to rebuild the entire progression system, and that doesn't happen just over the course of 3 weeks. The game took 2 years to make, so having to unpick all of those features, rebuild them, and then tie them all back together will take a little bit longer. Now, moving on briefly from those credit changes, tomorrow, Tuesday the 5th of December, that sees the launch of the Last Jedi season in Battlefront 2 and some faction-based challenges alongside the new content. You'll be able to pick either the Resistance or the First Order as your faction, and then you can fight for different rewards depending on which side you're on. We have new heroes, Finn and Captain Phasma. They will be in this drop as well, but they're coming on December the 13th, along with a new planet called Crait, that's from the new film, and a new Starfighter Assault map as well, called Dakar, I think. And lastly, some single-player DLC will be included as well, from December the 13th again. You can play as Iden Versio during the first days of the First Order's rise to power. Overall, this is a good update for the game, but I think we're all still waiting to see what DICE is doing in the background, working away to bring some big changes to how this game works and how you progress overall. No date of any kind for that at the moment, but as soon as we have information, I'll be breaking all of that down to see how it sits. everyone is looking at this game right now, and rightfully so, a lot of people are still quite angry, and it's up to DICE to deliver and improve on what they had before. Thank you very much for watching, and please leave some comments down below letting me know what you think of this update. I'll be reading as many as I can. But until next time, my name is Westy, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.